like a small boat on the ocean.
Years, the American Red Cross of Augusta has literally been my second home. I'm so thankful for the Red Cross and especially the Red Cross Youth Board that we have here in Augusta, because it's truly the experiences that I've had through Red Cross that have really shaped me into the leader that I am today. I've always been a big fan of the quote by Margaret Mead, to never doubt that a small group of thoughtful, committed citizens can change the world. But you know, after my experiences on Youth Board, now I truly believe that quote. I've seen students come together and raise over $25,000 in just a 3-week period for our local chapter. I've been able to witness how an effective nonprofit organization really runs by serving as the youth representative on our executive board of directors for the Adult Red Cross too. And I've also been able to develop so many positive relationships with local elementary school students by serving as a pillowcase project teacher and a mentor for them. I'm so incredibly thankful for the Red Cross. And honestly, I can't imagine my life without it, so I would love the opportunity to be able to serve alongside other student leaders who also share my passion for Red Cross and my passion for service on the National Youth Council. I'm so excited about the Red Cross that I know it backwards and forwards. Even the adults aren't afraid to send me in front of the media to talk about our Red Cross events.
Thanks for having us here today.
Things are going great. We only expected to fill up 1 to 2 trucks, and between Aiken and the Augusta location, we've already filled up 4 huge trucks today, so keep them coming.
Well, that's more than 100,000 bottles of water, is that correct?
That's correct.
And where are these bottles of water ultimately end up?
Well, the Red Cross has already opened about 30 shelters in these disaster areas. So they'll go to there, and they'll go for food and to feed the disaster relief people there. And they're also going to use the money to pay for medicine and other food.
And at this point, we have enough water. They're overwhelmed with it. As we said, 4 18 wheelers of water have been collected, but people still can help by donating. Is that right?
Right. We'll be here until 7 p.m. today and from 5 a.m. to 7 p.m. tomorrow. And we really like monetary donations. We've had so many water bottles go through here, but monetary donations for now is what we're really wanting.
All right, thanks a lot, Emma Cade. A lot of help from the Red Cross.
American Red Cross volunteers brought the Christmas this evening to a local retirement community. The Augusta Red Cross Youth Board hosted a Christmas party for the seniors living at St. John Towers in Augusta. They brought some homemade desserts and spent time bonding with their elders. A choral group from Davidson Fine Arts Magnet School even sang some Christmas songs.
It's a good opportunity for us to be able to tell them about positive things the youth are doing in our community, because I know a lot of the time it looks like we're not really doing anything, but you know, these are so many eager teens who are volunteering. To get to share that with them is nice.
The Red Cross Youth Board is accepting applications for teens to join. The deadline is in January of 2016. If you would like more information on how to join, visit redcross.org.
I'm surrounded by students who are as passionate about life and as motivated about their future as I am. I truly thrive in diverse environments filled with students who have nothing in common except a desire to serve our community. I truly believe that youth are the key to developing multi-generations of a service-oriented community. And that's why I'm so passionate about the National Youth Council, because, you know, I've seen firsthand the difference that youth can make. So just having the opportunity to be able to motivate not just a community or a state, but an actual country full of volunteers is something that I'd be very interested in.